Grand rising, loves. Happy Friday. Friday is the day ruled by Venus, and green is the color to connect with Venus. Venus is actually in a transition with Uranus right now. And I will be sharing a post about the energy that that brings in. But Venus is the planetary ruling of Friday. And Venus is about our abundance, but everyone equates Venus as the planet of love, but it also is financial abundance. So it's really a life of opulence. And how are you receiving? How are you manifesting for yourself that type of existence? And are you still buying into self-doubt, low self-worth, scarcity mindset? And really use the energy of Venus to draw those experiences in and improve those experiences of intimacy, finances, love, friendship, connection. So that is the planetary ruling of Friday. And Venus is the planetary ruling for the zodiac signs of Taurus and Libra. So for us Tauruses and Libra, I see Lisa's on here, probably really feeling ourselves on Friday. So the sacred geometry that showed up for today is the love and power, but it showed up in the reverse. And so if you look at this card, it's really the culmination of the human experience, and it involves all sacred geometry. And so the sacred geometry, oh, there's another Libra, Diana just got on. So love and power talks about the combining of all energies, masculine, feminine, dark, and light. But when you fully embody the frequency of love, then you are also able to harness your full potential and power. But unfortunately, that has been misused and abused and mistaught. So the whole battle and use of power is really inappropriate. And so it's not power to control over or power to manipulate. Power is always meant to be in service of. And so the balance of love and power then becomes the highest path of the spiritual body, the divine being. And it's a sacred use of love and power. And so love and power showing up in the reverse, it's saying that you are caught up in a loop of manipulation. You are misusing love and power, and you have a long way to go to retrain yourself. And so, like I said, this is an altar pull for the collective. The collective is everyone, including myself. So if this resonates with you, then it's for you. If it does not, then it's not. Now, what I will say is that I am constantly refining my human experience, because my decisions do not define me, they refine me. And I started realizing that I was surrounded by a lot of parasitic energy, meaning in every aspect, right? They are leeching not only energy from me, but also finances. Like, I found that the friends that I was spending time with, that I was always paying, and the males that I was spending time with, it was me who was always of service and not doing a whole lot of receiving. So was I having issues receiving? And so I started working on the receiving aspect of it, right? And then I shared this publicly in posts that I was on a 30-day receiving fast, like really paying attention and healing. What it really healed for me, I couldn't believe the things that were coming up for me. It wasn't so much that I was a bad receiver. It was so much that I held guilt around receiving and shame around receiving. And so it helped me expand not only through my solar plexus, but my heart, that wow, I do deserve this. Why am I feeling guilty for receiving? And so then realizing a deeper layer of that parasitic energy really didn't have anything to do with me receiving. So then I looked into my physical self and I started doing a parasite cleanse. And I haven't done a parasite cleanse on my physical body, on my earth suit, probably in about 3 years, because I like to do them periodically. And I was drinking well water in Washington State, and my digestion never was off, but my body was making a lot of noise, like a lot of rah. And I was like, wow, this is, I know my body well enough to know this isn't my body. And I never get ill. I've shared that many times. Like, when you become more spirit than human, you don't have physical ailments. And I stopped aging in my 30s, and it'll be less than 2 weeks now. I'll be 5 decades turn around the sun. I'm excited about that, y'all. So, I started doing this parasite cleanse and started realizing like that parasitic energy removed itself from my life. And then those friends, not all of them, but a couple of the friends actually started paying for me. And I was like, wow. And they even vocalized that, like, you know, I feel bad, you always pay, I wanna pay. And I was like, wow, but they, of course, the ones that were more parasitic are completely gone. Like, not even like a hello, how are you doing, miss you kind of text. But I'm grateful for that. So I realized like, wow, okay, so I worked on the receiving side. Now I'm working on removing parasitic energy. So always what you do for one, you do for all, but what you do in here affects the reality of your human experience. So love and power showing up in the reverse, and the reverse saying you have a long way to go. I mean, we all have a fucking long way to go. Let's be honest, right? If you are still in a physical body, you are still healing. So even the Grand Dalai Lama is still healing. I mean, that's the point of the human experience. We are constantly expanding and growing. And if you believe that you're healed, then you'll be back many times. So, because we are constantly expanding, and the more you know, the more you know you actually don't fucking know, okay? So I am in full surrender of this experience, but the paradox is that you have to embrace your humanness to actually elevate your experiences. And a lot of people try to bypass that, and that's the spiritual bypassing. Right? If I'm always love and light and I do this, I'm Teflon, and that's just not true, because the universe will always devise a way to bring your ass back down here and humble you. So that's the love and power in reverse. So Time Master also showed up in the reverse. And whenever a card shows up in the reverse, I don't get like twisted about it. I'm actually happy, because a card in the reverse is the medicine of the card. A card upright is the message, right? And so messages are usually affirmations like, hey, you're doing it. Keep doing that thing. And in the reverse, the medicine of it is saying, okay, if you tweak this a little bit, it'll get you back in alignment. So I never see it as like a smackdown or, ooh, like I don't ever get all twisted and get into fear when I see a card in the reverse, because I know a lot of people do, like, ooh, but I'm not twisted about it. Time Master in the reverse says, are you feeling like you're running out of time or don't have enough time? Because if that's the case, you're not aligned. So that's good, right? What did Lisa say? Yes, sometimes we should just say, fuck, and surrender. Yes, fuck it. Totally true. Yes, thank you, Lisa. And don't be twisted about the word fuck either, because I know some people get triggered by that, but it is the most versatile and powerful word. Just sit by yourself and say it. Like, the power of it moving through the vessel of the human body it really rakes up the sediment in all of that grit and removes it, right? Fuck. Good, just like that. It is a release. Thank you, Lisa. So anyhow, Time Master in the reverse is asking you, do you feel like you don't have enough time? Do you feel like you're constantly running out of time? Well, then you're not aligned. And, oh man, it's noon already. I didn't even realize. So, Miss Linda, our session's supposed to start at noon. I'll call you in a minute. Anyhow, so when you feel, okay, man, I just don't feel like I have enough time. I'm feeling exhausted. That's a really good indicator you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing. But not like, oh, that's wrong. It just means that's not aligned. Like, maybe you shouldn't be spending time with that person, or maybe that job is no longer in alignment with you, or maybe doing that favor should have been a no instead of a yes, and you're like stretching yourself really thin. Because when you're aligned, it seems like time is infinite. It kind of stretches time, and I love that kind of existence. And also, when you're doing something that you're really aligned with and enjoy, you stay present. That's the real difference. Because when you're not aligned, you do tend to get in your head and you'll time travel. That's the self-avoidance, like, because it doesn't feel good. It feels exhausting. And so just feel into that, the message of that. Ooh. Okay, battery's dead. Okay. That was fun. And so the stone of today, the tool, is aquamarine. And aquamarine is all about release. And I shared this aquamarine before because it's the only aquamarine I have, is this Happy Buddha. That was a gift. I want to get the light just right so you could see him. Anyhow, it's what do you need to release? And I love this because really right now and through the weekend, you should be really aware of all of the energies that have been coming up for this past moon month, because full moon is Monday. And full moon energy is so powerful to harness, to release. So what do you need to release? What are you moving through? What are you ready to let go of to move on? And the culmination of today's spread is Abuela Medicine. Abuela Medicine is the original medicine. It's not Tylenol. It's the medicine of our ancestors. And that's not only plant medicine, which it does talk about plant medicine, but it's also the medicine of the soul. What makes you happy? Because when the soul is happy, it rights everything else that's not right in your outer experience. Oh, good. Amanda says she's carrying aquamarine. And Douglas says full moon blessings. Thank you, Douglas. So, Abuela Medicine, are you honoring your soul? Are you doing the things that feel good, that feel aligned, that give you joy and expand your heart? The things that take you out of doubt, the things that take you out of fear. Are you surrounding yourself with people that feel like love, that feel like joy, that honor who you are, that you don't have to edit around, that you can be unapologetically you in every facet? And that's really the true Abuela Medicine. So that is the spread for today. Thank you for sharing your most valuable currency with me, this time and energy. I love you. And I am sorry for any misalignment that I myself have created. Please forgive me. I love you and thank you. I love you and thank you.